made on an MDF board. Design is Varli design, but we are going to make it with clay. So I'm going to show you step by step how we are going to make it. So you can follow the steps later and you can try yourself. I'm going to start. So we are not going to make exactly like this, but something similar to this. Design can vary. You can choose any design, you can choose any pattern. It's a, basically a Varli design. Means, see, you can see the pattern. Varli is figures like this. One day I will explain you in detail also what is Varli and how it is done, all the history behind it and everything. But today we are just going to make a quick one to make the wall decor. So for that, I have taken this MDF board. So MDF board is a board like this. This is not a cardboard, it's like this, very thick. You can take, this is, mine is very thin actually. You can take 4 mm for that. So this is 2 mm I guess, but I right now I have this only with hand. So I'm using this one only. So this is similar, the same as this, but I have just painted it dark blue. It looks like black here, but it's not black. I painted this color. So, but I have done 2 coats. So it looks like black, but it's very dark navy blue. So I'm going to use, so just to save time, I have just painted it beforehand. And we are going to use it for making the pattern. So first I'm going to draw the pattern. So I'm just putting the camera a little down so that you can see it all. So because we have to make border actually, first I'm going to make a border like this only. I like this one because when we paint it, it gives a very nice look. So, but before that, I'm just going to put where my design should be. Design in the sense, where the people which I'm going to put it, I just need little symmetry. So I'm just going to do it this much as the border, this much above. I'm just going to draw one line only just to have a idea where my people should stand. So just vaguely, I'm just going to draw the line here from the beginning here. Somewhere with this white pencil, I'm drawing this one. And then it should be how big? I just don't want too big here. So I think this should be enough. So just to have a symmetry, that's all. Yeah, rest we are going to do it ourselves. So that's fine. Okay. So for that, I'm just for the time being, I'm keeping it in the side. I'm just going to take this air dry clay. You can take any brand. Mine is this one here. I have this also. This is air dry clay. So this one, mine is this one. Yes, that's. This one is air. You can take any air dry clay. Anyone, anyone. So I'm just taking it. I have kneaded it a little bit because you need to, you are required to knead it a little bit so that the air bubbles just go off. Otherwise, if air bubbles are there, then later it doesn't give a very finished look. So I'm just going to roll one line. We have to keep it in plastic wrap because it dries very fast because it's hot weather. So I'm just putting it rest of it. So I'm just going to draw a long line for that border in the side. So I'm just going to roll, I've taken a little air dry clay, I'm just going to roll it. So you can make it thick, you want to make it thin, your choice. Width can be anyhow. So I don't want very fat, but little bit because it's going to add little volume to the side. So I'm just going to roll it, little bit I'm rolling it, just to make it symmetrical one. And how long I want, I can just tell you. So this one is here. So I'm just going to now put the glue. So again, any white glue. So the glue which I'm using it here, I can show you. So this is the glue. So when you're using these things, this glue for these things, just make sure you are not using school glue. You are using, it can be all-purpose glue. It can be wood glue. It can be craft glue. So any other glue will be okay, just school glue is not meant for these purposes, so it will not be durable. So that's the only difference. So just make sure that you take all purpose or craft or glue like this. So I'm just going to put little glue. This is the same white glue in this bottle. So I'm just going to put it here in the side. So so that it can stick it properly. So now I'm just going to put it here. So I'm just pressing it little, just to give it little fat, flat look. And I'm just going to make it little wiggly. Can you see that? It's not very straight. So I'm just going to give it a little curve here. Then it goes little out, it goes little in, again it goes little out, it goes in, out, in, and then just it rolls over here and I'm going to cut it. So this, if you want, you can do it straight also, not a problem. So I'm just going to cut it here. So here I've just cut the corner. Here also I'm going to cut the corner. So I've just cut the corner. So anything, if you want to finish it here, so I just put little water and just make the edge little neat. Okay, so this is like this, little wiggly line here. And then after this, I'm just going to put it like this, little marks on this. These are my hair pins, so I'm just going to put it here, so like this. So I have just put little pressure, not too much, little flat I made it from round, but now when I'm pressing it, little more pressure is there and it's getting even flatter. So that's these marks will give a very good texture and look when we paint it. Because we are going to paint it first this blue color only, or black also we can put. And then on top of that, with the dry brush technique, we are going to do maybe gold, maybe metallic gold, maybe bronze. So we'll see which color we choose later. So right now I'm just going to put it here, these patterns, because this needs to be done before it dries up. Once it dries up, then you can't make these patterns. So you have to do it now only. So if you want to leave it just like without pattern, so you can, but I think these pattern look a very rich look to this. So you can, if you don't have this clay tool, you can do it with anything. You can do with a knife also. I have a lot of clay tools, so I just got the opportunity to use them. So I'm doing it. Yeah. Then I'm going to roll another one. Other side, I'm just going to take here, same way. So I'm just putting it in the side because I need space to roll it. So I'm just rolling it here. So I can roll it both the sides to make it a little longer. See here. Rolling is your own style. You can roll with one hand, two hand, whichever way. I just roll with the palm of. And you want to use gloves? You can use gloves. I don't use gloves. I like this way only. So we try to make roll it the same size, same width, like same fat, so that it gives a symmetrical look. You would have heard a lot of times this word symmetrical from when I talk. I really love symmetries. So I want the things to be like, you know, same both the sides, both the edges. So if it is little fat here, you roll it here. So like that only you can do it here. So little bit here, I roll here. So if it is longer than the required length, that's okay, then I will cut it there. So I think this is fine, good enough. Here it's little fat, I just want to make it little thin here. Yeah. So because this is a handmade thing, if little here and there, it's okay. You don't need to worry too much. Just enjoy the process. It's really, really very satisfying. So you just enjoy the process when you're doing it. Don't worry too much about how it's going to come. It will, anyhow, it's going to come nice. So you don't need to worry for that. So again, I'm this side, I'm going to put the glue. I'm doing both the longer sides first. So here. Okay.
Okay. So I'm just going to put it here again. Same way. I just make it little wiggly. So I don't see whether it's a wiggle up or wiggle down. It's anyhow, it's fine. Okay. So I'm just going to put it here. Inside, out, in, out, in, out, in, out. Oh, it's just complete, almost exactly the same size. So I'm just going to cut it from this side also. Little bit outside is there, I just cut it here. This is almost same, so it's okay. Yeah. So again, I'm going to make this pattern with this. So same way, so I'm just going to make this one here. So when I'm making this this design, but you can actually make many others also. So one day I'll show only the textures, what we can make with the clay and even with the ceramic powder. We'll do that one day. It's very easy. So when we do it, it doesn't take much of the effort, and like you have not to be very on guard what to do, how to do kind of a thing. So they just come nice anyhow. A few things are which do not require too much effort, but the result is very good. Few things are, they require too much of effort, but result comes only when you really input a lot of effort. So this is something which is quick fix kind of a thing. Yeah. So I'll just see if my this side is complete, so that we can have three sides then. Now I will have to be a little careful while cutting it, so that it fits in between. So I'm just going to cut from one side first. So I'm just cutting from one side there, so that it goes there. I'm just putting glue here. Then I'm going to stick it here. So I'm just fixing it with that. So I don't need to, but I'm just putting slight glue in between also. It will fix because it's still wet. When it goes together, it will join. Okay. So this is little smaller, so either we add it, we roll it little bit, we don't add it because then it will be show up the joint. So we just roll it little longer. It's very less short. I just didn't realize. So it's very little, so I'm just going to roll it here so that it fits in. Yeah, it should be fine now. So here, so this is inside, I have done it here, out, in, out. I'm just doing it one curve in, one out, and I'm just gently going to cut it here. Yeah, so I just join it here. Okay, so where you feel that you need little finishing, you can just add a dash of water and just smoothen it up, so it will be fine then. It should be fine. So this is in, out. Like I didn't follow any specific thing, it's just that, just to make it randomly in and out thing. Again, I'm going to make this curve here. Yeah. Okay. So here. So I'm just putting very gently, I'm not pressing too much, very gently I'm just putting this, so the marks are coming. This will make an impact when we are going to paint it. So for this you can use knife, any other any object which has little edge, so that's fine for that. So I'm not doing the sideburn here because I just want to do it faster so that you can see that. So I'll do it later, but I just want to show you the whole other pattern. It will be faster, so I'll just try doing that faster. So I'm just taking a little more clay here, saying this is a dry clay, so I'm just going to make it here. I just put it back into the air tight bag. So I'm just taking which I need it right now, and then rest of it I have already put here. So I'm just going to put it in the side because we don't need it here. So now I'm going to put this one here. So first we have to make the base here. So I'm just going to make it a very thin strip here. So I'm just going to cut it here. I'm just going to put a little talcum powder so that it doesn't stick it here. So I'm just, because I need a straight strip, so I'm just rolling it a little bit first, and then I'm going to roll it like a chapati. So this is the rolling pin for this one. So I'm just going to make it here. So I just want to see how fat I want and how long and how wide I need. Yeah, fatness is okay. So I just want it. I need to have triangles. So I'm just going to cut the triangles here. So I just can put actually the ruler, and I can make them, just cut it here because I need all of them same size. So I've just cut it here, and even at the bottom I'm going to cut it here. Yeah, so now I'm going to cut it so that it's very fast and easy process to stick them. So I'm just going to do it here. So these are triangle, so I'm just going to cut it one by one here. One. Okay. So I'll smoothen it up when I'm going to stick them. Two. Three. That way the size remains the same. So you don't need to worry which one is bigger, one is smaller. So I'm just going to cut maybe 8 here. So this space I have to see how much I need, but I'll just cut randomly whatever I can, because right now I have already rolled the clay. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Oh, there are too many. Yeah, I think they're good enough. So I'm just going to put one by one here. I'm just going to take water here. So I'm just going to make the edges smooth. So if you can see that, there's little edges here. So I just make the smooth with just a drop of water. So all the edges I have made it smooth. So I'm just going to put glue here. So basically this is the space as if it's a road kind of. So I'm just going to put it starting from here. I just want to leave little bit for the margin, this much, and then little bit just to start with. So it should be fine here. Yeah. So then I'm just going to put it another one upside down. So this is my little water added. Just a drop. You don't need too much water. It's just a drop to just smoothen the edge. It's very easy. So I'm just going to put glue every time I put this so that it sticks nicely. So I'm just pressing the edge. I don't want that sharp edge here. So one is going to be upside down, one is other way. One is normal triangle, other way is upside down. So we are going to do it this way. So now the third one, again same way, I'm just going to put little water. And this one. So I'm just going to put blue here. So this one is going to be here this way. I'm just going to put it this way so that they all look the same size. Then I'm going to put here. Okay. Getting sticky. Okay, here. So again this way, right? Yeah. So again I'm just putting little water. Actually I wanted to show you the whole process, otherwise I could have made like before and just tell you the process and just simply show you, okay, this is the done work. But I think this way it comes better to understand what is the process. So you tell me how you want it. You want me to describe the whole process, or you just simply want that I do it beforehand and just showing you the steps and do the like just demo to show you this is how it's going to be. Because it's only I'm making for you guys, so whatever way you feel confident to understand. So if you feel that you can understand by looking at the thing when I show you the steps, so I can do that way. So please put into the comments to tell me how you want it. So I'm just going to put another glue portion here. So these edges have come because I have cut it with a knife, so but that's okay. I can actually gently cut the edges also. So here I can do it once I attach them also, after that also I can do. So I just see how many, one more I think, yeah. So we still have more to go, so this should be fine. I hope you are able to see that here. Yes, then again one more and then we are done with this. So we are going to start making the people. So same way I just put it here, right? Yeah. So as long as it doesn't dry, you can move it little bit if you feel that you want to change the design or something like that, or it has shaken or something like that. So then it's fine, otherwise. Okay. Okay. So I'm just going to show you now the next step. We can use these actually triangles for the body also, but I just make it again because I want all the pieces the same size. So this one again I should have put into the bag. It's drying up fast, it dries up very fast. Okay, here. So I'm just rolling it a little bit. I'm just going to make the people and the plant and one animal. So first I want to make the people here. this much will be people here, this much will be animal. Same way, I'm just going to put little talcum powder so that it doesn't stick. And then I'm just going to roll it and then make it here this way. Good. The size we can decide, we can just roll and then we decide whichever size we want, we can cut out of it. So I'm just making it this way. Okay. So same way, I'm just going to cut with this now. So we need, for body we need four triangles, two, one for upper body, one for lower body, and one for man, one for woman. So we need four of them. So I'm just going to cut four. So I'm just going to cut from inside so that it comes neat here. So we don't need too many. So I'm just cutting in this fat portion here. Okay. So now we need only four of them. So just going to put this inside. It's really drying very fast. It becomes so dry the moment I put it outside. So now I'm going to make four of them. So this can be triangle of the similar size or slightly bigger. I just want them to be. So because we can make the size of the body whichever we want. One, two, three, and four. So this one is the extra one. I'm just putting it here. So I'm just going to stick it here. This is also extra. So we'll back into this one. Okay. So I'm just going to stick it here, people, just roughly I just see where people should be. So if this is the legs, and this one is here, this one is here, and the face, okay. Yeah, okay. Okay, it seems to be very big. I'll have to cut it a little bit more because it's really big for the space. Otherwise it's fine, but it's big for the space. We don't have that much space here. So. So you can always make it smaller or bigger, your choice size. Yeah, this is fine now. Because if we make it too big, then it will look like we won't have space for the sun. And we want to make the sun there. So we are going to make one man, one woman. Okay, so I'm just going to put the glue here. Okay, so little water, just making the edge little neat. See how it becomes the neat when you put just a drop of water. You can always smoothen them up. So I'm just going to put it here, and then below this, the lower body. Again, I'm just doing it here. So I'm just going to put it here. Then I'm just going to make the first the legs and arms for this, because then we will know where to place the body for the women. movement. So I'm just going to roll it here. So the legs and arms are going to be just the rolling here. We need thin one now, because based on the size, we need thin. We don't want very fat. So I'm just rolling so that we can have two legs. So this much should be okay. So I'm just going to cut two and then I see how it fits in. So I'm just going to put glue like this. Glue will dry transparent. So it's a pretty big here. So I think this much should be okay. I'll just put and see. I don't know yet. Yep. So it fits in here. So I'm just going to put it here, just make it a little edge here, okay, yeah, so that this one also I'm going to just cut here, and okay, here, so I'm just going to make a edge here, or this is longer, so I need to cut a little more. Then again, this one I'm going to make the edge for the leg and then I stick it here. We prefer to be same size because legs have to be same size. So that's why if I have to cut, I'm just doing it same size. Okay. Yeah. So this is done now. The one person is done for the legs. Now we are going to make the arms. So for arms again, same thing I'm going to do. I can just roll it any further. See here. So I'm just going to put little talcum powder on my hand because it's getting sticky. I just want to roll it. So little more rolling. We want little thinner arms. Here. So here should be fine, I think. Okay, here. So I'm just going to make it roll it here and then we are going to stick it. So we just see if it is, yeah, seems to be good enough for the arms. So I just want to cut it smooth here and this side also. Okay. So I'm just going to make it smooth here and then edge again. And the arms are going to be, because this one I want here. And the other one has to go up. So right now I want the arms to be stick so that I can estimate where the woman is going to be. So we are going to put the other arm up there later. So we just do this one and then we make the woman here. Woman here. So we can just actually make it a little more neat with the clay tools, any of the things we can. So we can just put it here. So you can always smoothen it up, smoothen the edges with the water, just a drop of water and it will be done here. So I just want to make this edge here. Okay. So now I have to make the other one. Other arm for the woman. So I'm just going to put it here because they are just holding the hands. So I just want to put it here and then I'm just going to stick it here and then I'm going to make, after that I'm going to make the woman here. So I'll get an idea where I have to put the woman body. So that's the reason I did it now, otherwise I could have done it even later. Like the other arm, and I do it. The other one I can do it because that has to, the man's arm has to go up. Why it goes up, I tell you. I'm just going to do it here. So again, I'm going to put it here. You can make the same size, not issue. And I just put it here. So I'm just going to put it here. And then I'm just going to make it here or slightly smaller. Just makes it slightly smaller. Looks a little big. Just to fit in the space, otherwise there is no problem for big or small, that's okay. Just to fit into that space, it looks a little big. Yeah, it's a little kind of messy work, but if you like the messy work or you like to see how it comes as a final outcome, then it's fine. For me, anything messy is fine. Like, I enjoy the whole process to do it. I just don't think about too much, like why it's messy or something. So I'm just going to do it here. So this is here. And then the lower body, see, it has already started drying up in the meantime when I was doing that one. It really dries fast. I'm doing it here now. Now I'm going to make this one for the legs for the woman. So I'm just going to roll it, same thing here. So if you think that you need little more clay, but I think for the legs it should be fine. Actually, right now it should be fine rolling it here. So I'm just rolling it here. So then I'm going to make two arms for this, and then one arm will go up there. Or first we make the legs, then we see for the arms also, because now we need to put the faces so that we know if where the hand will go for up, going up. Yeah. So for the legs, I just see first approximately and then I'll cut it together. So it's still longer, it's pretty long. Yeah, so I'm just going to put glue here. Yeah. This also, I'm just going to give an edge like this and just stick it here. Just make sure that you stick it to the body, like it's okay anyhow. I'm just making little edge here for the leg. Yeah, okay. So arms we will do it later. First we are going to do the head. Because one arm has to go up, even for the even woman also, the arm has to go up. So, because she is holding a pot, that's why arm has to go up. So first we will make the pot, and for the man, he is holding a bunch of wood, twigs. So we are going to make that one first. So I'm just putting little water because it is little dried up. So once I do it, once it becomes little smoother, so then I'm going to make the head. Again, same thing. I'm just going to put it a little bit here. So I'm just going to roll it. So same way, I've just rolled it now. I have this plungers. This is a round cutter, so I can just cut it with this. You can use any round object to cut. So I'm just going to take it here and just putting little glue here and here and just putting these faces here. Oh, it's stuck here. Yeah. just up here. So I've just taken it out and just put it here. Okay, so I'm just, because there is little space for the neck, I'm just going to put just a teeny weeny dot here in the place of neck. So just a little bit of neck. I've just fit in a little bit. Here for the neck, it's done, right? Yeah, okay. So now we have to make the pot for the woman and the
Hi Kishwar. Hi Tarla, long time. How are you, Tarla? Hi Anamika. Tarla, you're still in Mauritius? Or in Dubai, I guess.
So now I'm going to make a pot for the woman. So again, same way, I'm just going to roll it here. So the pot, we can make it round, any shape we can make it. So we need a little bigger object if you want to make it round. So I just don't want to make it round. I'll just cut any pot shape here. Like this. Little curvy. So yeah, it's good enough. So then I'm going to put it there and I'm just going to shape it there. Little round at the bottom. So I'm just making a pot here. She's carrying the pot for the water. So this has to be a little round here. And this round here. So size, I think it should be good enough for that. So I've just made the shape for the pot. So I've just made the edges neat now and I'm going to stick it to woman's head. So it's going to be here on the head. And the man has to carry something on his head too. So what I have done is, I just want to put something on his head. So he needs to carry a bunch of twigs. So I don't have anything else. So I've just taken this few sticks from the broom. If you can see that. So this is normal broom which you use in your home. So I've just cut few sticks from there only and I'm just going to put it here, stick it here, and then first I'm going to put it roll here so that they don't get separated because I have to make them stick here. So I'm just going to put it with the clay first, tie it with the clay. So I just tie it with the clay first and then I can do it here. So I'm going to make a very thin tie for this one. On top of the twigs I'm going to put it here. So I'm just gently, I cut it and put it on top of this. So we can just stick it to them together also. If I put some glue, they will all stick together. Then on top of that I can put the twigs to stick them together. So I'm just going to stick it here, little glue here, just to put it tight together. Yeah, I could have put it tied together also first. Yeah. So I'm just going to put it here, glue, and just this tie here, and one tie here. Going to look natural how he is carrying the sticks when they come from the forest, picking up the twigs for their daily life. Okay, yeah. So this is done. Now we have to do it here. We are going to make the animal here. So I'm just going to make animal very quickly. We are going to make it here. Same way, again I have to do the same process. So that was the reason that I wanted to do it a little more in the background, like I keep ready the things. But then the thing is that if I keep the things ready, then you won't be able to see how I did it, the process. So I'll just think about something so that I can do a little faster instead of this long video. So I'm going to make the body for this animal. So same way, I'm just going to cut two triangles. So I'll just see how big I want. This is, yeah, same. So I'm just going to put it here. So this, I'm just going to put it little, you know, slanty. So this is same way. It goes here like this. And the other one goes up there. This one is little bigger. I'm going to cut it little smaller. So that's how I put it here. But I'm just going to shift it a little bit behind because we need the head also to put. Okay, here. So we shift it here. So animal, maybe it's a goat. So I just cut it the face here. Okay. So I'm just going to make a little ovalish, any shape, little oval. Okay, so only thing is now we have to make this one for animal. We are going to make four legs. So So we are going to make four of them same size. So this is because my hand is too much sticky with the clay. So this is the fourth one. So I'm just going to roll them to make it smooth here, and four of them here. So all four, I'm just going to stick them here. So I'm just going to make edge for the front ones. Yeah. You can cut it there, it's little longer. Yeah. So I just cut it first. Okay, so this one is the legs for the front legs for the animal, and then I'm going to put the back legs here. Again, they are a little longer, so I just cut them beforehand only so that they fit in there. So this one is done. Okay guys, little more is done. We need to make a plant and little bit rocks at the bottom and sun. So I'm going to do it and finish it, and then I'll show you the final outcome, how it comes. So bye for now.